Orlando man was arrested over the weekend after police say he was caught secretly videotaping up a woman's skirt. Police found the cameras on him, but WESH News investigates discovered police made an unusual decision that one legal expert says could hinder this prosecution. Investigative reporter Matt Gratt live in Orlando with more. Matt.
Well, Martha, we're in front of Total Wine on East Colonial. It's here where authorities say a suspect hid a camera inside of his shoe and used it to secretly videotape a woman. Now, police apparently had evidence, but that suspect was able to destroy it while sitting in their own police cruiser. According to the arrest report, 67-year-old Robert Grease was busted for snooping on an unsuspecting shopper.
I just feel like these creeps are showing up everywhere.
The victim's boyfriend held the suspect until police arrived. According to the report, Grease was read his Miranda rights after the officer observed two small camera lenses plainly visible underneath his shoelaces. Grease was placed in a patrol car but was not handcuffed, a decision WESH 2 News legal analyst Richard Hornsby questions.
It's a little bit unusual that it didn't try to seize that camera first before placing him in the patrol car.
Left alone, Grease was spotted tampering with the camera. According to the report, police recovered five pieces of the micro SD memory card, which was not enough to rebuild it. Hornsby says that could make conviction a challenge since you have to prove the person was actually videotaping someone's private area.
Unfortunately, without the actual videotape itself, it's going to be very difficult to prove that.
What he believes prosecutors can prove is that Grease tampered with evidence. Like video voyeurism, that's considered a third-degree felony and carries the same punishment of up to 5 years in prison.
At the end of the day, he may have saved himself from being convicted of video voyeurism, but he's assured himself being convicted of the tampering with evidence.
Orlando police couldn't get a hold of the officer who made the arrest. They say generally they don't always handcuff someone who they're investigating for a crime or who's being detained. We did stop by the suspect's home. Nobody answered. We're live in Orlando. Matt Grant, WESH 2 News.